Hello everyone! In this tutorial, we're gonna look at how work the hue, saturation, and luminosity in your images by creating three tools and use them to match values between two different pictures. And if you're kind, it may have a gift at the end. We're gonna take pictures for this example because it's convenient, but it's exactly the same for digital painting. So we have a background image and a subject that I masked, which belong to another image, and obviously different values. First, what is value? Even if it's mostly associated to luminosity, it's simply a scale for measurements. The main ones to us for a digital screen is hue, saturation, and luminosity, as well as an alpha value that we don't talk today. To make our pictures look as unique one, we're gonna take problems separately. Luminosity first. You find it vertically on your color selector. Basically, we're gonna use a simple black and white adjustment layer at the top of the pile. As luminosity is the intensity of light, 0 is totally black, and 255 full white, the brightest light. To be more accurate, you could change the blending mode to color, but it's also a personal taste. It's easy to spot the differences between the two pictures. As the subject is in the foreground, it could appear more contrasted, but darks are too deep, and it doesn't match with the background. So we are gonna put a curve adjustment layer, clipping it to the top of the subject picture by pressing Ctrl-Alt-G, and change the blending mode to luminosity, as we only wanna work on luminosity. All you have to do is stick to the background values by raising a bit the blacks, boosting a bit mid-gray and highlights. Icing on a cake, you could make a S shape on your curve to bring back a bit of contrast. Okay, it's a bit better, we see a difference, but it won't make it. Let's check saturation now. Saturation is pigment intensity. You'll find it horizontally on your square or as a diagonal on a triangle color selector. To do this, it's a bit more complicated. We're gonna create a selected color adjustment layer in which we have to change the mode to absolute, either it doesn't work. And for each color, we'll pull the blacks all the way down. Not the same for tones, black, grey and white, as we're gonna raise the blacks to the maximum, plus 100. Now you get this fancy black and white map, black is 0, no saturation at all. If you're on black and white, you could easily check by activating the luminosity layer, everything turns black. Pure white will be a maximum saturation of 255. To match saturation, we'll simply use a hue and saturation adjustment layer, clipping it to the luminosity correction and change the blending mode to saturation to avoid other values. So we're raising the overall saturation to match the darkest part of the image, but it's way too much on the face, for example. To counter that, we're gonna find a sampler, click on the face, selected tint will be red as it's a color we find on every skin tone, no matter the ethnicity, and now we could work with a specific area. We could refine as we want, in the yellows here, maybe a little. Last step, colors. It's obviously the chromatic wheel around the color selector, red, green, blue and so on. To focus this specific value, even if it could appear obvious, we're gonna add a solid color layer, fill it with a 50% gray as it carries no saturation and no hue, and change the blending mode to luminosity. All of this helps us to easily see the hue even in the darkest or the lightest areas. And if you change the gray value in the solid color layer, you could adjust the intensity accordingly to your painting or your compositing. To match hue, add a selective color adjustment layer and change the blending mode to color. Clip it to the saturation adjustment, Ctrl+G, and we have all the family now. First, select the blacks and make changes colors by colors to match darks and ones from the background. Note that red is the opposite of cyan, green of magenta, and blue of yellow. It's not really obvious on this tool. Now, you could work on midtones. And then on whites. Finally, let's edit all colors separately. It's important to identify all the colors in the background and match as much as you can colors on your subject. The tricky part will be in the reds and yellow with this subject. Green and blues aren't that much frequent and magentas as well. Once it's done, bypass the color control layer, and everything should be more consistent now. Before and after. It's even more obvious with the original picture. So now you have all the tools to make the best control on your values for digital painting, compositing, photo bashing, perfect match, it's up to you. And as Christmas is not so far, you'll find a Photoshop action linked in the description that creates this free Ashison maps in a group ready to use. You only have to change the mode to absolute in the saturation maps as it can be recorded. If you enjoyed this tutorial, next time we're gonna dig blending modes on multiple videos because we'll cover everything. Feel free to subscribe to don't miss any videos and drop any ideas in comments. I'll always try an explanation if it's possible. See you next time!